Hi friends, welcome to Alpha Mathematical Institute, Avadi, Chennai. Now we will discuss a problem on partial differential equation. Directly we will move on to the problem. If u of x, t is the solution of dou u by dou t equals to dou square u divided by dou x square, where 0 less than x less than 1, t greater than 0, with the initial condition u of x, 0 equals to 1 plus x plus sin pi x into cos pi x, and the boundary conditions u of 0, t equals to 1, u of 1, t equals to 2, then u of 1 by 2, 1 by 4 equals to 3 by 2, u of 1 by 2, 1 by 2 equals to 3 by 2, u of 1 by 4, 3 by 4 equals to 5 by 4 plus 1 by 2 into e power minus 3 pi square. Fourth option, u of 1 by 4, 1 equals to 5 by 4 plus 1 by 2 into e power minus 4 pi square. Okay, so actually here one dimensional heat equation is given. This is one dimensional heat equation, dou u by dou t equals to dou square u divided by dou x square, where x lies between 0 to 1, and then the initial condition is given by this expression u of x, 0 equals to 1 plus x in plus sin pi x into cos pi x, and then boundary conditions are given by this expression u of 0, t equals to 1, u of 1, t equals to 2, right? So we have to find these values, u of 1 by 2, 1 by 4, and u of 1 by 2, 1 by 2, u of 1 by 4, 3 by 4, u of 1 by 4, 1. Okay, so now let us first study the one dimensional heat equation, right? The one dimensional heat equation is this, dou u by dou t equals to alpha square into dou square u divided by dou x square. This is the general one dimensional heat equation, dou u by dou t equals to alpha square into dou square u divided by dou x square, right? So call this as equation number one. The boundary conditions are given by this is u of 0, t equals to 0, u of l, t equals to 0. Okay, so on the end 0, u of 0, t attains the value 0, and another end l, u of l, t, u of x, t attains the value 0. Okay, so this is a homogeneous boundary condition. Then the solution of this equation 1 is given by this expression u of x, t equals to summation n equals to 1 to infinity bn sin n pi x divided by l into e power minus n square pi square alpha square t divided by l square. Okay, so the solution of heat equation satisfying these two boundary condition is given by this equation number 2, right? And then the initial temperature is given by this expression u of x, 0 equals to f of x. You call this as equation number 3, and then this as equation number 2. So if you use 3 in 2, you will get f of x equals to summation n equals to 1 to infinity bn into sin n pi x divided by l, because instead of this t we have to substitute 0. Okay, so this e power 0 will come, e power 0 is nothing but 1, so it will become f of x equals to summation n equals to 1 to infinity bn into sin n pi x divided by l, for x lies between 0 to l. Right, now this looks like the half range Fourier series expansion for the function f of x. Okay, so by calculating the half range Fourier sine series expansion for f of x, we can find the bn value, right? So the half range Fourier sine series expansion of f of x is given by this expression, f of x equals to summation n equals to 1 to infinity small bn sine n pi x divided by l, right? Now you just compare this equation, this fourth equation, and then this fifth equation, will get these bn's are equal. So bn equals to 2 by l. Actually this is the Fourier coefficient, bn equals to 2 by l into integral 0 to l f of x into sine n pi x divided by l into dx. This is equals to capital bn. Okay, so once if we calculate this capital bn, then our job is done. Okay, therefore u of x comma t is equals to summation n equals to 1 to infinity, instead of bn we have to substitute this expression, integral 0 to l f of x into sine n pi x divided by l into dx, instead of bn this one, into e power minus n square pi square alpha square t divided by l square. Okay, so this equation 7 is the required solution of 1 satisfying the given boundary condition and the initial condition 3, right? Now in our problem, the boundary conditions are not zero boundary condition. In the our problem, the boundary conditions are non-zero boundary condition. Okay, suppose non-zero boundary condition comes like this, u of 0 comma t equals to some a naught, u of l comma t equals to some a1, then assume that u of x comma t equals to u1 of x plus u2 of x comma t be the solution of the wave equation, dou square u divided by dou t equals to alpha square into dou square u divided by dou x square, where this u1 of x is called steady state solution, and then u2 of x comma t is called transient state solution, and this u1 of x is steady state solution, so it is independent upon t. So if I differentiate that u1 of x with respect to t, it will become 0. So alpha square into dou square u divided by dou x square will come. So alpha square is non-zero, so dou square u divided by dou x square equals to 0. So if I solve dou square u divided by dou x square equals to 0, I'll get u of x as ax plus b. So that is what here we have written, u1 of x as ax plus b. This u1 of x satisfies the condition u1 of 0 equals to 1, and then u1 of 1 equals to 2. So using that condition, I am getting u1 of 0 equals to, here instead of x I have to put 0, so I'll get 0 plus b equals to 1. So finally I'll attain b equals to 1, and then u1 of 1 equals to a plus b equals to 2. Already we know b equals to 1, so a equals to 1. Therefore we will get u1 of x equals to x plus 1. U1 of x equals to x plus 1. Next we have to come for the transient state part. So u2 of x comma t is called transient state part, right? So now you consider the given equation. So we'll consider the given equation. So this is our given equation, dou square dou u by dou t equals to dou square u divided by dou x square. Compare with the heat equation, we will get alpha equals to 1, right? So boundary condition for this equation is u of 0 comma t equals to 1. It is given, but we know u of x comma t equals to u1 of x plus u2 of x comma t. So this u of 0 comma t can be written as u1 of 0 plus u2 of 0 comma t, which is equals to 1. But this u1 of 0, already I know u1 of 0 is 1, so this u1 of 0 and then this 1 will get cancelled. So finally I'll attain u2 of 0 comma t 3 equals to 0, right? So next u1, 2, 1, t equals to 2. This is next boundary condition. So it is nothing but u1 plus u2, 1, t, which is equals to 2. Already I know this u1 is nothing but 2. So u2, 1, t is nothing but 0. So my another boundary condition for u2 is u2, 0, t equals to 0, right? So next we have to look for the initial temperature, okay? So the initial temperature is given by this expression, initial temperature u(x, 0) equals to 1 plus x plus sin pi x into cos pi x. Already we know u(x, t) is nothing but u1(x, u2(x, t). So it will become u1(x, u2(x, 0) equals to 1 plus x plus sin pi x plus into cos pi x. So this u1(x) already we found as 1 plus x, so 1 plus x plus u2(x, 0) equals to 1 plus sin pi x into cos pi x. Now this 1 plus sin pi x, this 1 plus sin 1 plus x 1 plus x will get cancelled. So we will get u2(x, 0) equals to sin pi x into cos pi x. You call this equation as equation number 9. Clearly this u2(x, t) satisfies the heat equation and had satisfying the homogeneous boundary condition, because u2(0, t) equals to 0, and then u2(1, t) is also 0. Therefore this u2(x, t) satisfying homogeneous boundary condition, and then this initial temperature u2(x, 0) equals to sin pi x into cos pi x. Therefore we can solve u2(x) in a similar manner. Therefore this u2(x) is given by this expression u2(x) equals to summation n equals to 1 to infinity bn into sin n pi x divided by l into e power minus n square pi square alpha square t divided by l square. Here l equals to 1, alpha square equals to 1. Therefore my u2(x) will reduce like this: u2(x, t) equals to summation n equals to 1 to infinity bn into sin n pi x into e power n square pi square t. Just substituting l equals to 1 and alpha square equals to 1 here, you'll get u2(x, t) equal to this expression, okay? So call this expression as equation number 10. Now use equation number 9 in equation number 10. So equation number 9 is nothing but u2(x, 0). u2(x, 0) is sin pi x into cos pi x. Here I have to substitute t equals to 0. So it will become summation n equals to 1 to infinity bn sin n pi x into e power n square pi square. Instead of t, I have to substitute 0. So this is e power 0 will come. E power 0 is nothing but 1. Therefore this sin pi x into cos pi x equals to summation n equals to 1 to infinity bn sin n pi x, right? So here we know the formula sin 2 theta equal to 2 sin theta cos theta. Using that formula we can write this sin pi x into cos pi x as 1/2 into sin 2 pi x, which is equals to, you just run this summation. First if I put n equals to 1, I'll get b1 sin pi x. N equals to 2, I'll get b2 sin 2 pi x. N equals to 3, I'll get plus b3 sin 3 pi x plus etc. It goes on. Okay, so here this left hand side contains only sin 2 pi x term, right? So but right hand side contains sin pi x, sin 2 pi x, sin 3 pi x plus etc. These terms. So comparing the coefficients of sin n pi x on both the sides, I'll get b1 equals to b3 equals to b4 equals to etc. equals to b5 b6 etc. equals to 0, and only value is b2 is non-zero, which is equals to this is b2, b2 is 1 by 2. Therefore u2 of x comma t equals to if I open up that summation b1 b3 b4 b5 b6 everything is 0, b2 alone non-zero. So u2 of x comma t equals to b2 into sin 2 pi x into e power n square. N square is nothing but 2 square pi square t. Therefore my u2 of x comma t is equals to 1 by 2 into sin 2 pi x into e power minus 4 pi square into t. Now we calculated u2 of x as like this, 1 by 2 into sin 2 pi x into e power minus 4 square 4 pi square into t. Already we found u1 of x equals to 1 plus x. Okay, so our aim is to calculate what is u of x. Therefore u of x is nothing but u1 of x plus u2 of x. This is u of x, right? So u of x equals to 1 plus x plus 1 by 2 into sin 2 pi x into e power minus 4 pi square into t. So this is important. U of x comma t equals to 1 plus x plus 1 by 2 times sin 2 pi x into e power minus 4 pi square t, right? So now we look for the first option. First option is we have to find u of 1 by 2 comma 1 by 4. So instead of x I have to substitute 1 by 2, t I have to substitute 1 by 4. So if I substitute here, I'll get u of 1 by 2 comma 1 by 4, I'll get 3 by 2, right? So next I have to look for 1 by 2, u of 1 by 2 comma 1 by 2. Instead of x 1 by 2, t 1 by 2. So if I substitute and simplify, I'll get 3 by 2. And then next u of 1 by 4 comma 3 by 4. So instead of x I have to substitute 1 by 4, t 3 by 4. So if I substitute and simplify, I'll get 5 by 4 plus 1 by 2 times e power minus 3 pi square. And then next u of 1 by 4 comma 1, instead of x 1 by 4, instead of t 1. So if I substitute and simplify, I'll get 5 by 4 plus 1 by 2 into e power minus 4 pi square. Now let us see the options for this question. Okay, so for this question all the options are correct for this question. Okay, first option correct, second option also 3 by 2, third option correct, fourth option correct. Okay, so for more videos please subscribe to Alpha Mathematical Institute. Thank you.